I'm about 1 hour outside of San Antonio, Texas today, at one of my new favorite tiny homes. This place has so many amenities, I'm definitely gonna forget to name some. Let's see, there's a hammock, a hot tub, a double outdoor shower, a fire pit, a soaking tub, and this gorgeous roll-out bed that you can take out outside at night. You can look out into the stars, because there's plenty of those out here in Texas Hill Country. So can't wait for you guys to see this place. There's a lot for us to cover. Let's now go and start the tour of this beautiful tiny home out here in Texas. We will begin the tour up in the skies with the drone. This is what Texas Hill Country looks like. We are right on the outskirts of the town of Hondo, Texas. But now into the yard, one of the first amenities you'll come across is this comfy hammock. We'll now move further into the property and we'll come to the hot tub. Now next to the tub, you have this bag. There's a net inside if you want to clean the tub at all. There are also two towels and this little contraption if you want to enjoy some drinks while in the tub. But this is actually an inflatable hot tub. I've never seen a hot tub like this before. And later in the day, if you'd like, you can turn on some string lights that go right over the tub for some added ambiance. Next up, we're gonna move to this fenced off area. And if we walk inside, there are two chairs on the left side. And as we peek up, this is your double outdoor shower. As I'm sure you're beginning to notice, this property is definitely meant for a romantic couple's getaway. Just outside the outdoor shower, you have this heavy duty Blackstone grill. Also nearby is one of my favorite outdoor areas. You have this beautiful fire pit. It's very easy to operate. You just flip on the propane and hit a button and you are good to go. Anybody can figure it out, even myself. Also in between these two comfy outdoor chairs, you have some grilling supplies like some spatulas and cooking oil. I learned that the weather in Texas Hill Country can change very quickly, so this fire pit is a must. If we continue more to the front, you have this lovely outdoor dining table. You have a little candle in the middle as well. So this is a great place to have your meals outside. Now this is your main front exterior. I loved everything from the paint job to the wood trim to all of those windows, especially the main window in the middle, which is actually a garage door. But more on all of that later. We're now going to hook right and head to one of the last exterior amenities. This is a soaking tub, which means that there is cold water inside. You then, of course, have your hot tub on the other side of the property, so you have both options. In addition, you have those two comfy Adirondack chairs and plenty of pillows to make up this space. There is a lot to see outside, so we're now finally going to open up these double doors and come in to the interior. Welcome inside to this gorgeous tiny home. The home is made up of three rooms, this main area that you see right now, and two smaller rooms in the back, which we will get to later. When I asked the owners, they told me that in total, this tiny home has a little over 250 square feet of interior space. One of the key features is obviously this huge bed, which is very well appointed with a bunch of pillows. Also, right above the bed, you have this decorative piece, which I think is quite fitting for Texas. There are little nightstand tables on both sides of the bed. For the nightstand on the left, you have a charging station, which is always very much appreciated. Then on the right, you have some books and a Bluetooth speaker. On top of the bed, you have some items waiting for you, like your keys, the guest book, which I definitely suggest you flip through, and some reading material, like this field guide to birds. We'll now move into this corner, which has a very comfortable red chair. There's also a bunch of goodies in that basket, like some DVDs, this old school DVD player. I haven't seen one of these in years, and a bunch of games like Uno and cards. But overall, you have a bunch of entertainment options in this tiny home. If you walk to the opposite corner, you have this cute rounded table with even more freebies waiting for you. I mean, just look at this lovely setup with the two wine glasses and this free bottle of wine. You also have this candle. It was a pumpkin weather candle the time that I visited, and some fresh eggs. Right next to the table, you have this large bench, which is covered head to toe in more brilliant decorations. Throughout this entire tiny home, you have candles and cool lighting fixtures like this. Finally, on the bench, you have a detailed guidebook waiting for you. That's it for the main area, so we're now gonna slide back this door and walk inside. This will take us into your kitchenette. I thought it was very well equipped, especially considering the sheer size of this tiny home. But as we pan from top to bottom, I'll go into more detail. You have your sink over there on the left, a bunch of kitchen knives and utensils. Up top, you then have a microwave, your bowls, plates, and mugs, and down below, even more appliances like a toaster and your fridge. On top of this main counter, you have a bunch of coffee and tea supplies. Inside of this box, you have a ton of tea bags. Finally, if we slide back this door, it contains even more space with items such as your coffee filters, salt and pepper, and plenty of pots and pans. If we now go to the other end of the tiny home, we're going to slide back this door on the left and now walk into our bathroom. I thought the bathroom was very well designed, especially the sink area with those three separate shelves or countertops to help optimize the space. Up top though, you have your gorgeous sink and a slew of bathroom amenities all around. You also have your shower on the opposite end, which was very clean and had great water pressure. Finally, if we slide the door back again, you have even more bathroom items waiting for you. Everything from your shampoo, conditioner, and hair dryer. Now onto one of my favorite features by far of this tiny home. We're going to lift up this garage door. It's a lot lighter than it looks, I promise, and we'll begin to roll out this bed. I would definitely advise having two people to roll this bed out, as I almost lost control of the bed a few times, but let's now begin to set up this area. And here we are, all good to go. You'll notice that I turned on the string lights, brought around the fire pit. You can even add in some of those candles and lighting fixtures if needed. It's quite a photogenic, or as you may say, Insta-worthy setup, but again, perfect for a couple just to lay out on top of the bed and gaze up at the stars. Or if you're single, like yours truly, you can just sprawl out on the bed and take a nap. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and make sure you are subscribed. You can also check out my tiny home playlist down below, and I will see you next week for a brand new Airbnb tour.